So let's see to where it is installed. Okay, so it's right here, WEKA 3.8.3. So I'll click on the WEKA 3.8. Okay. So I'll just click on OK here, just a warning information telling that we can use many learning schemes and tools. And in the tools menu, okay, click on OK. And so let's get started in building our model. So why don't you click on the Explorer button? So in this WEKA Explorer, it allows you to intuitively build your prediction model by clicking on specific functions. So let's get started by importing the data set, and the data set that we're going to use in this practical tutorial will be the famous IRIS data set. IRIS dataset is a public domain dataset that is commonly used as an example dataset for teaching data mining. And let's find it. So click on the open file. Go to the C drive. Go to the program files. I'm not sure whether it is program files here or program files with x86. So let me try the first one. So there should be a folder called WEKA. Okay, so it's in the program files. WEKA 3.8. Go to data subfolder and then find IRIS. Okay, here you go, iris.arff. Now they also have the IRIS 2D. So let's go with iris.arff. Click on open. And then this is what we see. So let's have a look at what this the various feature or menus are doing. So in this panel here, it tells you about the attributes or the variables that this data set has. And so we can see that there are a total of 5 variables. The first one being the sepal length, the sepal width, the petal length, the petal width, and then the class. So this data set is a data set of 150 flowers that are closely related called iris. And they are described by 4 variables: the length and the width of the sepal, the length and the width of the petal, and then it is for each flower it is given a corresponding label as being either acetosa, a versicolor, or a virginica. And so here we can see again that, okay, this is the iris data set. It has a total of 150 flowers, and there are 5 attributes or 5 variables that we see here. And if you click this, if you click on it, and to the right, you will see some description about it. So you can see that there are 50 iris setosa, 50 iris versicolor, 50 iris virginica, and there are no missing data here. That's good to know. So clicking on the first variable, we can see that the minimum value is 4.3, the maximum value is 7.9, the mean value 5.843 with a standard deviation of 0.828, and then we get the same information by clicking on the subsequent variables. So we see the minimum, maximum, the mean, the standard deviation. Okay, so notice that the numbers here, mean and standard deviation, it really depends on the average value of each variable, and then the standard deviation would just tell us the variability of each variable. So before we build a prediction model, let's first start by normalizing our data, because each variable will have different minimum and maximum. As you can see, the first one has 4.3, a minimum of 4.3, maximum of 7.9. Second variable has minimum of 2, maximum of 4.4. The third one has a petal length of 1, maximum of 6.9. The fourth variable has a minimum of 0.1, maximum of 2.5. And we notice that the mean and standard deviation of each one of them are different. So let's get started by first normalizing or standardizing our variable. So let me begin by normalizing the minimum and maximum to be 0 and 1. So we can do that very easily in WEKA. So we have to click on the arrow, unsupervised attribute, and then click on normalize, and then apply. So before I click on the button, notice that the minimum maximum are 0.1, 2.5, 1 and 6.9, 2 and 4.4, 4.3 and 7.9. So I'll click here, apply, and notice what changed. What changes? So the minimum value becomes 0 and 1. And we also notice that the mean and also standard deviation also differed. And here, same thing, minimum, maximum, 0 and 1. Third variable, same thing, 0 and 1. Fourth variable, 0 and 1. Or alternatively, so I can undo that. Alternatively, so that will bring us back to the original state. So alternatively, instead of normalize, I could use standardize. So it's in the same subfolder, filter, unsupervised attributes, and then I'll find the standardize. So click on standardize, click on apply, but notice that the mean and the standard deviation will be altered. So we see that they are 5.8 here, 0.8 here, 3 and 0.4, 3.7, 1.7, 1.199, 0.763. So click on apply. Okay, and so the mean becomes 0 and the standard deviation becomes 1. So this will happen for every one of them. Third variable also. And also the fourth variable. However, okay, so nothing happens to the class because that is the class where we are going to make our classification. So in data mining, there are many tasks that you can do. You could visualize the data, you could cluster the data, you could classify the data, you could build a regression model. But for this example, because our class or our output label is a qualitative label, therefore we will perform classification. By classification, we mean that we will categorize each of the 150 flowers into one of the three class label here, either as a Setosa, Versicolor, or Virginica. So this step is called data preprocessing, where we normalize or standardize the variable. So decide on one of the or the other, either normalize or standardize, but not both. So do one or the other, and when you are ready, go to the next step, which is to go click on the classify tab. So let's click on that and then go to the classifier. So choose a classifier and let's go with a how about a decision tree. So let's begin with a J4.8. So this is essentially using the C4.5 algorithm by Ross Quinlan. So click on the J48 and then the default for doing the test would be cross-validation using a tenfold. So I'm going to cover this in a future video about how you can split your data set into training and testing, and also how you can do the cross-validation set. So in this tutorial, I'm going to stick to the default. And so click on the start button and then your prediction model will be constructed. So you have seen that it takes only a couple of seconds, not even a second, so maybe half a second to create your model. So here, this is the summary of your prediction model. So let's start by scrolling up on top. Okay, so this provides a description of the algorithm that you're using. You're using T48. You have 150 sample size. You have 5 variables. You are using tenfold cross-validation. And this is the resulting decision tree created, found inside your prediction model. There are a total of 5 leaves. The size of the tree is 9. And then these are the performance metric of your prediction model. So you see that you have a 96% accuracy in correctly classifying 144 out of 150 flowers into one of the 3 classes correctly, and that we have 6 that we have misclassified, and then we have kappa statistics here, mean absolute error, root mean squared error, and others as well. We also are provided with the true positive rate, false positive rate, precision recall, F-measure, MCC, or the Matthews correlation coefficient, RLC, and the class. So here we are given the performance metric for each of the 3 classes. And then this is the average weight of all the 3 classes. And the confusion matrix is provided below. So what is the confusion matrix? It allows you to see how your prediction model is confused. So if you look under the hood, you have 50 flowers for each of the iris setosa class, 50 flowers for iris versicolor, and 50 flowers for iris virginica. So out of 50, we have correctly classified 49. And we have misclassified one of them. So A, right here, A is represented by iris setosa. And so for the iris setosa out of 50, one of them is misclassified to be B. B is iris versicolor. So we can see that one flower that is supposed to be classified as iris setosa was misclassified as iris versicolor. Okay, so going to the second line, we see that 47 iris versicolor have been correctly classified, and 3 iris versicolor have been misclassified to be iris virginica. Okay, moving on to the third row, 48 iris virginica have been correctly classified as iris virginica. However, 2 of the iris virginica have been misclassified to be B, or iris versicolor. So this is very useful in helping us to understand the confusion made by our prediction model. So until next time, I'm Chanin Nantan Senamat on the Data Professor channel. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please consider subscribing and clicking on the notification bell so that you will be notified on the next video. So I'll see you in the next one.